You see, I still got a gap there, but since the steps are going to be so short, I'm just going to use a lever to try to work it over the rest of the way. Just, I put the counterweight in the middle, and I'm just going to try to lever the block over and walk it over one end at a time. Crossed on the bottom there. I added some counterweight to try to tip the block this way, but in order to get it any closer, I'd have to tip the whole block. That would take quite a bit of levering on the other side.
Okay, thank you for giving me a chance to show you what I've been doing. And after this video, I have some clips of earlier projects I did. And until I get a chance to do another edit, thank you very much.
Everything. Okay, we're going to attempt to move this barn today using the techniques involved that I've rediscovered and forgotten technology. We're going to attempt to move this barn by hand. Barn weighs probably about 15 tons altogether. It's a 30 foot by 40 foot barn, wood siding, asphalt shingle roof. Come on, let's take a look at the barn. Shore this barn up so we can balance it and use the offset fulcrum and pivot points. I added probably 4 or 5 tons to the building. You can see I got 5 girder trusses in here. These are steel trusses. They probably weigh around 800 to 1,000 pounds apiece. I got a hickory log there. That log probably weighs about a ton. It's 26 foot long. Maple log over here is close to the same weight. My center support log is a hickory log, and that probably weighs a ton. Very sturdy. And I've added a bunch of shoring and stuff. I haven't tried to lighten this barn at all to do this. not quite there yet. That's real close. Now, what we're going to try to do is to transfer the weight onto one point. And actually, in turn, what we're going to do is walk the building. In order to do that, here we got to go to the outriggers. What I've had done here is add two outriggers to the building so I can add some counterbalance weight so I can balance on one point to the other. As you can see, the building is kind of rocking back and forth. But as you see, when we do start to walk the building, either inertia or centrifugal force, I don't know what you call it, it helps stabilize the building.
Okay, when I first got started here, it was really muddy, as you can see all the water there sitting on the ground. Also, too, the trees were in the way there a little bit. I was rubbing on the trees. I ran this a little fast forward. The first several spins I just did alone until it got going. You can see by the calendar here on the bottom, I started this in September of 2000. I spent some time here waiting for the ground to dry it up. I was anxious to get going just to see if the thing had worked, though. Every time I'd do a half rotation, I'd have to move my counterweights to the other side and reset the jack. Each time I reset the jack, I'd have to push some shoring into the ground until I hit it stable. As you can see, there's a little trench there. That was really kind of rough to cross there. There was a lot of water in it. I had to dig that trench down in order to cut them posts off. It went pretty good once the ground dried up. And I got off on the grass over there. Once the rotation of the building get going, the faster it'd go, the easier it'd be. Rotation of the building creates stability. You see, my kids wanted to jump in here and give me a hand eventually. Everybody wanted to try it. First started the building off over here by the trees, moved it over there, it's about 200 feet.
I'm ready to go with it. I'm going to try to take it outside.